when I was 15 was when the film came out, and that's when I was first brought to Hollywood. And here was this new town, and I had a great time, but there was something about it that I was always very restless throughout the years in Hollywood. There's just, I think there's a lot of people out here that are, they're trying, you know, they're all trying to be an actor, or they're trying to do something, and they're very frustrated, and there's a lot of people that use people, and you get caught up in all of this conflict. I think what people don't realize within my career was that when I was 18, I was busted for drugs. Only what they didn't know was that I really didn't have anything to do with the incident. It was a cover-up for, there was a senator's daughter involved, there was a lot of things, and people got the wrong impression of Linda Blair, and they thought I had a drug problem, and I did not know this. So I was basically blackballed in Hollywood. I did a magazine called We, an Italian Playboy, and the pictures were shot for a purpose, to show people that I was no longer a child, and that I also had a lot to say, I had a lot on my mind that nobody would listen to. So that's why I did the article. Unfortunately, the pictures have kept running, as they will do, and people have gotten the wrong image of me. I was only naked from the waist up, so I wouldn't let them, I mean, I don't believe in anything for myself. There's no way. No way. But from the waist up, it didn't bother me because, I mean, everybody, it's a human body. And I think that's what people don't realize. A human body, everybody has one. Sexually, I'm very passionate, but I'm also very shy. I'm not like a, I'm not an exhibitionist or anything. And I think people didn't realize, and they didn't realize until they saw the pictures, that when they heard about the magazine, they would just assume that they were pornographic pictures. Whether or not they're very artsy and they're very beautiful pictures, and everybody that seen them said, wow, those are really nice. And that was the purpose of it. So until they see it, they don't realize what I did. Hello. I think one of the things that was very interesting that happened in my life was I started working with a man named Dr. Leroy Perry, because throughout my life I've had a lot of problems with my weight. My back was damaged during The Exorcist. I had rotated hips, and I had a lot of problems with my feet. So what I'd like to demonstrate sideways is you can see, by standing like this with your butt out and your back arch, you're doing damage to your spine, and you're kind of, if I'm like this, I'm kind of slumping. Whereas if I roll my pelvic bone up and I come a little bit over, my lean over my, is like over a little bit in front of my heels. And by standing up straight, shoulders back, my whole body starts to become in one line. Now, the best way to remember how to do this is by thinking of a helium balloon, which is attached to your pelvic bone, and lifting up. And you may think of that in your favorite color. If it's purple or blue, then when you think of purple or blue, you think of being up. And you also put one on your chest and on your head, so that your line is very straight. And from this, you will slightly lean forward, and this goes into a walk, which, when we walk, what we want to remember is that we do not want to strike with our heel. This is incorrect, and a lot of people walk this way. This puts damage onto your back. It starts collapsing your spinal area. What you want to do is you want to land about an inch or two in front of your heel. And then you will roll off the entire foot and off your toe. And in other words, so it keeps in a forward rolling motion. You want to keep your body straight, pelvic bone up, chest up, head up, and walk a little bit at a forward lean, not, like I said, keep very straight. And by doing this, your whole body starts working within itself. So here we go. See? Did a film lab in 1983 and 84 called Savage Streets. And so I've never had a poster out, and what they did is they tied it in with the film. It's like a female death wish, and as a matter of fact, right now it's out in Europe, and we tied in the poster with the film, and so there it is.
Do you like yourself in that poster?
It's a side of me, sure. For film, I couldn't play romantically because I don't look it. Now I'm just starting to come into myself. I think the next 10 or 15 years will be the best work that I've done. I did a movie called Sweet Hostage with Martin Sheen. And that's a love story. I was 16, he was 34. And there's a love story there. You know, and that was neat, but it just depends on the type of situation that they want. And for me to look my age, it's taken this long. Being in the industry and you grow up fast and you have to learn things fast, I have learned so much in a space of time that most people learn when they're 30, 40, 50. And I knew I learned them within the first 20 years of my life.
You talked about conquest and conquer. What is the hardest thing you feel at this point in your life you have to conquer?
Life.